I presume I have some footage of getting stuck here in the mud. I'm really in deep there too. So I'm gonna see if I can, with the help of those two little boards there, if I can unstick this thing without Karen's help. I would like to do that, but if necessary, she'll come and help me then. So I'll just I'll leave this run and you can watch. Well, that's what I was afraid of. I guess I'll just have to wait for her to get home, and I don't know what she's gonna do. Yeah, well, that's the way it is. I may have to get somebody to come with a tractor and pull me out. I'd hate to do that. Well, this is my solution to the problem. I've jacked up this side and put some short boards underneath it. And I'm going to do that to the other side too. And then I hope with a lot of gas I'll just be able to keep moving out of there. Looking at it, I'm wondering now if I shouldn't have gotten some more boards or longer boards or something. I have that brown one there. Maybe I'll use that. Once I get moving onto the drier ground in the back there, I'll be able to keep it going. But of course, now the tires are completely full of mud. Oh well, I'm going to put the other side up and then we'll see. Okay. In case anyone's wondering, I do have the mower deck raised as high as I possibly can. So I have both sides up on boards now. We'll just have to see what happens when I... Well, there you are. I finally got it out, and what a mess that was. I'm going to have to just wait here until it dries out before I can mow down here. It's not important, really, anyway, but I didn't realize it was that wet. I called Karen and told her on the phone, and she said, "Oh, I meant to warn you, down there it's it's like a river down there." Well, I probably wouldn't have listened to her anyway, who knows. Okay, so that's, I think that's it for this adventure.